Throughout our offerings of both courses in the Blockchain Fundamentals program, we've received many questions about mining Bitcoin in real life. This section aims to share our experience doing so and some do's and don'ts for the curious. So here we have it, real-life cryptocurrency mining. Mining cryptocurrency at first may sound like printing money or money growing from digital trees, but there are some things that need to be considered. First of all, one ought to choose profitable hardware. The older stuff won't cut it. Out-of-date hardware will often consume more electricity than would be profitable to mine with. Second, mining software differs depending on the intent of the miner. Do they only want to mine one specific currency, or are they willing to switch to whatever is most profitable at a given time? Does the miner want to mine in a pool or solo? These are all software-side decisions to be making. Monitoring miners is another concern, especially for those who are just starting out. Uptime, temperature, and profitability all need constant vigilance, especially with changing markets and changing seasons. If not careful, mining rigs can be fire hazards. Conversion between fiat and crypto is another point to consider. Whereas power bills will be paid in fiat, you will be earning your payouts in some cryptocurrencies, and sometimes this may be tricky to spend. Please do your own due diligence before deciding to both mine or invest in cryptocurrencies. The goal of the average cryptocurrency miner is similar to that of the traditional businessman, to minimize time to break even and maximize return on investment. One of the ways to do this is to optimize hardware costs on the assets that maximize rewards. For mining, this consists of GPUs, PSUs, and fans or cooling. Graphics processing units, also referred to as graphics cards, were all the rage in cryptocurrency mining, especially prior to the release of ASICs. They hash at a rate significantly faster than CPUs and thus are essential components in a mining rig. Because hashing rate directly determines your mining payout, one would want to spend the big bucks on the GPUs. PSUs, power supply units, are equally important, as they are needed to power the mining rig. Higher-end PSUs are more efficient and waste less power, whereas a bronze-rated PSU may waste up to 10% of power being provided to your rig. A platinum-rated PSU may only lose around 1%. Because this directly affects your profitability, you definitely do not want to pinch your purse here. Fans and cooling are also a significant component of your rig. Overheated components perform poorly and poses risks as fire hazards. Hence, it's crucial to keep your cards cool. The non-essentials of a mining rig are all the components that are neither keeping you safe nor bringing in the money. CPUs are largely inferior to GPUs in terms of hashing power for most algorithms, with the notable exception being CryptoKnight. Thus, most miners would prefer to purchase a cheap CPU and use the savings to purchase an additional GPU instead. Memory is also non-essential, as generally lower-end RAM will suffice. Just make sure it's compatible with your other hardware. Disk falls into a similarly unimportant role, with less than 50 gigabytes of hard disk being more than plenty for SPV or pool mining. This should cost $30 or less. Other external components, and even a computer case, are unnecessary for a mining rig as well. It doesn't need to look pretty, it just needs to get you paid. In terms of software for mining, some common options are NiceHash and Multipool Miner. Multipool Miner is a less beginner-friendly tool, which also allows automatic switching to most profitable cryptocurrencies and their corresponding algorithms. They take less of a cut compared to NiceHash, but are a little less friendly to operate. Solo mining as a full node for a specific currency is also an option. We would not recommend it for anyone new to the game. As we alluded to earlier, break-even time is generally a good metric to measuring successful cryptocurrency mining. Ideally, every business endeavor wants to minimize the time until break-even, and maximize the profit multiplier of their investment. To do this in cryptocurrency mining, the two main factors are cost of electricity and cost of hardware. Depending on one's location, the cost of a kilowatt hour ranges drastically, a huge point of consideration for everyone thinking about mining. As an example, California's cost per kilowatt hour is more than double that of Louisiana. The formulas for time to break even and return on investment are provided below. That does it for our intro into building a cryptocurrency miner. This is by far the most frequently asked question. Please feel free to continue engaging in the discussion boards. If we find another frequently asked question, we'll make another FAQ video to answer it.